this game, we'll see the Phoenix Mercury going up against the Seattle Storm. And from a great basketball city, Seattle, I'm Blake Zuniga with our 2K experts, Tim Schwartz and Brian Vanifatemi. Happy you've come along. It'll be the Storm off the tip. Pass to Talbot. Lloyd. Stewart, covered by Little. Stewart can't hit. Now digging Smith. The basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
What a passer. Diana Taurasi sees the game like few ever have. Finds teammates in great positions.
Here's Talbot. To the inside. Skylar digging Smith with the steal. Pass to Taurasi. Griner with the ball. Guarded by Bird. That one goes. Count it.
Not afraid to play rough and rugged. Griner shows the ability to power through contact.
Out to the left wing. Bird with it. Fires the three. Gian Erse the rebound.
Well, with a clear look at the basket, she doesn't really miss a lot of those.
Count it. Good.
That took serious skill for Erse to score when she's being, you know, hit like that. Tremendous.
Outside Lloyd. And it's blocked by Diana Taurasi. And she recovers it. Back to Bird. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
There they go, finally able to drop one in on their fourth try.
Now here's Taurasi, covered by Lloyd. Good on the shot.
Four straight makes out of the gate. That's just a nice start.
Now Bird. Here in the first, with just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Soft touch off the glass.
Not an easy basket from Bird, but she has tremendous body control. It's helped her throughout the years.
Pass to Griner. Here's Little. One up, one down. 2 points with her first shot in this game.
They've been hot here early, dropping them in left and right.
And we'll see how long they can keep it going.
And the shot goes in.
Getting easy buckets for teammates. That's what Sue Bird does, and she's been doing it for a long time.
Diggin Smith, guarded by Bird. Pass to Erse. Shot clock at 6. And here's Bird. First quarter of action and just under 3.5 minutes played. Pass to Magbegor. The shot will not fall. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Now here is Stewart. Here's Talbot. Back to Stewart. To Bird. Good. And Brianna Stewart gets the assist.
Smarts go a long way, and Bird has learned how to navigate under the hoop. Even standing at 5'9", she can score inside.
Now here's Taurasi. Little with it. And she sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
Nice pass. She got that ball right into her teammate's shooting pocket, and it yielded great results.
Pass to Lloyd. And here is Stewart. Here's Talbot. Shoots over Little. That's no good. Couldn't get her first shot to go. Here's Taurasi. Let's go with a three. Buries the long-range jumper.
A gifted shooter, Taurasi can knock down shots from well beyond the arc. Really extends the defense.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over.
Ladies and gentlemen, dance team.
teams will make substitutions. Now Burke. Outside Dupree. And again, it's the Storm missing. Now here's Walker. She's tightly guarded. Dupree grabs the board. The Storm trail. And here's Samuelson. To the paint. And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw.
Sixth pick in the 2006 WNBA draft. Dupree has been putting up numbers for a while.
Now here's Taurasi. She's got five. Hartley outside. From 20 feet out, it's rebounded by Seattle.
Even though she missed it, she couldn't pass up that chance.
Yeah, they don't come much easier than that.
From 12 feet out, and a shot by Burke, no good.
That's a shot she's got to hit. You don't get too many better looks from that range.
And she makes that one.
Driving is an effective element of Taurasi's game. She does not play casual basketball.
Here's Samuelson. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Pass to Canada. Six to shoot. Here's Magbegor. The shot that time, not on target. And it's Phoenix the other way.
They have a narrow edge here rebounding early on, and you wonder what kind of role that's going to play moving forward.
Oh, it's such a tight game. Every play counts.
Canada with the bucket.
And the crazy speed of Canada coming in handy in transition. Love watching her run the floor.
Timeout called the Mercury. Here's Hartley, looking for her first basket still in this one. It's Megan Walker on the wing.
Rebounding is going to be a focal point for them in this one, fellas.
Yeah, Brian, it has been so far. They've already got a nice edge on the glass.
Out to the wing, outside Canada. Clock at six. Her shot is good, making her a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
Well, we've seen that more than a few times. Easy bucket in the paint.
The interior defense at that end has been lifeless, to say the least.
Now here's Taurasi. She's got seven. And again, Phoenix no good.
The defense can't make a habit of giving her that shot. She just doesn't miss many of them.
Magbegor, it's good on the putback, and that ties it up.
They continue to get it inside. The defense struggling to just contain them.
And look, when you make five in a row from in tight like they have, it also just takes pressure off of your perimeter guys.
Great point.
Taurasi drops in the layup for two. Canada with it.
Don't give us back! Don't give us back!
pass to Burke. Inside. Dupree misses.
Great defense right there to prevent one of the best finishers in the league from converting in close.
Absolutely no fear, guys. Mixing it up in the paint with bigger players.
And it's good for two.
Really like the tenacious play from Canada. Refuses to back off of her shot because of the contact.
Now here's Taurasi. She's got nine. And there's the whistle. Illegal screen.
You have to make sure your feet are set. But when you set those screens, they'll get you for it.
I thought maybe she was set. Now, I know that's a difficult call to make, but I think maybe they got that one wrong.
Canada.
With a high motor and a never give up attitude, Diggins Smith can play quality defense when she's locked in.
We're at the end of one in a close game so far. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in a moment. Before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen from the Storm?
There hasn't been a lot of settling for outside shots really early on.
Yeah, they've done a good job to work it low and not take the easy way out on offense. No shortcuts.
Pound it low.
Pass to Griner. Walker. Here's Hartley. Six on the shot clock. The three ball. Offensive board. Got a piece of it. Here's Samuelson. She's guarded by Griner. Here's Walker. Stolen. And stolen by Brittany Griner. Good.
Just an incredible display of athleticism. Now, Griner's active on both ends of the floor, and her coaches appreciate that.
Now, here is Canada. Pass to Burke. Shot clock at six. And close on the shot, even with the foul. Now, the two free throws. It's on Bria Hartley. This is her first opportunity at the line this evening.
Kennedy Burke. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Both teams deciding to change it up. So she gets them both. Phoenix with the ball. Now Diggins Smith. Here's Griner. The shot is good, and so is her shooting tonight. 3 for 4.
That might be the last player in this league you want to get an offensive board. At 6'9", Griner can get the ball back up and in real quick.
Bird no good.
That's definitely a situation where you want to make sure you don't give her too good of a look.
Absolutely, and the defense better not relax because she might hit that one next time.
Phoenix in the lead. Here's Hartley. A rebound by Brianna Stewart. Pass to Bird. Back to Stewart. Griner with the rebound.
Yeah, remember that. And that's not an opportunity. She fails to convert very often.
Count the basket.
Reads the defense so well. It's really what makes Diggins Smith the top-notch point guard she is.
Outside Stewart. That kick out to Bird. And again, it's the Storm missing. Left side, Diggins Smith. Down low, Griner. It's good. The assist that time from Skylar Diggins Smith.
You want to stop Griner when she's attacking the hoop? Didn't think so. Too much coming at you.
Pass to Burke. Rhea Hartley with some nice D. Now here's Diggin Smith. Out to Nurse. Beyond the arc. But they get it back. She muscles it in through the contact. They call the foul, and she's on her way to the line.
They've been the glass eaters today, guys. Just a ton of effort out of them down low.
And they've needed every one of those rebounds. That's what's put them in front. The late blossoming of her offense has been incredible. Griner, her scoring average improved by 5 points during season 5 of the WNBA.
Now a timeout called by Seattle. Nice game, great performance by Brittany Griner.
She's been taking it to the rack all game long. If they don't find a way to slow her down, it's going to be a long night.
Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Pass to Talbot. Dupree up top. To stop the run. And the ball out of play, the Mercury will have it.
That is an unforced error if I've ever seen one, guys. Just not an ideal pass.
The possibility here of pushing their lead into double digits.
Mentally, that would give them even a bigger edge.
And here is Hartley. Here's Griner. Clock at 6. Yes, and it's Rhea Hartley picking up the assist.
And Hartley is a quality distributor. Realizes it's a big part of her job to share the rock.
Pass to Stewart. Outside for Dupree. Talbot. Over Diggin Smith. Talbot, no good.
A solid performance inside. You know, their rebounding, it's been terrific.
They're putting together a great game, aren't they? Strong performances throughout, and they've just been strong on the glass.
And it sets a tone.
Out to Nurse. Back to Diggin Smith. Gets a three-pointer to fall.
Well, Diggin Smith gets set up to shoot there. He's on the receiving end of a pass for once. Love the confidence she has in her shot.
Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over.
Yeah, I think the coach is trying to take the wind out of their sails here. They're on the wrong end of a run and need to sort things out offensively and defensively.
Yeah, things were starting to spiral out of control on them a little bit, and a timeout was a no-brainer there. Yeah,
exactly, Brian.
Changing it up here. On defense, Phoenix. They've only given up 2 points this quarter. Outside, Stewart. 6 to shoot. Out to Lloyd. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there. Up top, defended by Stewart. The shot, and it's Seattle with the rebound. To the
middle.
The basket good off the assist from Sue Bird.
At 6'4", with her abilities, it's almost impossible to stop Stewart down low.
Pass to Griner. Now to Rossi. And she makes good on the layup.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it seems like it's come from inside the paint. Buckle up on defense.
Yeah, it's time to collapse down and make them shoot jumpers.
Here's Magbegor. Out to Lloyd. And here's Griner. She's got 13. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Defended by Stewart. Taurasi outside. Ooh, no luck on that one. Now Seattle takes it the other way. And they're looking for some kind of spark here.
Yeah, full stretch offensively. They need a bucket.
The will, the desire. When Stewart is locked in offensively, there's little you can do to stop her.
And the Mercury call time here.
Noticing the squad was getting a bit worn out there, and coach called time to let him grab a drink and revitalize.
Built a very nice lead.
No chance of slowing down, at least as far as I can tell.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Pass to Turner. Taurasi, covered by Lloyd. And Taurasi is good for three.
She's been one of their more reliable options today, and it's her shooting that has given them this lead.
Here's Samuelson. Magbegor. Here's Stewart, and she battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
Well, she's shot a very good percentage today, and her team has needed every last bit of it.
Megan Smith's shot is off. Left side, Stewart. Lloyd. Pass to Canada. Foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two.
With her abilities off the bounce, Canada will earn trips to the line for a long time in this league.
And this is her first free throw of the game. And she makes the first.
And Jordan Canada is known for her defensive prowess, all-defensive member. But on the other side, also her passing and playmaking ability. She's a special talent with a winning mentality.
Both good at the line.
And working themselves to the line here in the second, a nice way to get their offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way. That could pay off as well.
Now here's Taurasi. 14 points for her. Rain Kakakunwe, good.
She's got a great read of where that miss was going, and that enabled her to be the first player to it and get the putback.
Canada with it, guarded by Diggins Smith. Here's Samuelson. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Magbegor. And it's off the back of the rim. No good. Both loose. Jordan Canada with the steal. Second shot opportunity. And Stewart, the lay-in, it's good.
Tip your hat to Stewart, maybe the best player in the world. She still does the extra little dirty work inside.
Taurasi outside. Teardrop shot. And it's good on the lay-in.
It's hard to find fault with anything she's doing this quarter. Well, offensively at least.
Outside Canada. Pass to Magdegor. Right wing.
1 second left.
And that concludes the first half. It's the Mercury. They lead by 13. And we will be right back after halftime for the start of the third quarter. See you in just a bit. Seeing a tremendous game from Taurasi.
What I noticed more than anything about her first half offense was she didn't waste her opportunity. She made just about every good look she had.
And they were pretty much all good looks. I mean, her shot selection has been phenomenal throughout the game.
Getting back to the action now, it's been a one-team show so far, but we'll see if that changes. Pass to Nurse. Brittany Griner, high post. The basket drops and she gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up for her.
That's the kind of physicality coaches love to see. Griner shows the ability to convert through contact.
And this is her second trip to the line in the game. Bird. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Well, she, for one, hasn't let them down, but a few of her teammates need to pick up the pace and pick it up fast.
Now here's Nurse. The teardrop falls in.
What fantastic touch from Nurse. It's a huge ace up her sleeve. The ability to put it in the hoop from inside.
Talbot defended by Nurse. Bird outside. Clock at six. Outside Lloyd. Shoots the three. Griner with the rebound.
You got to give them credit for the job they've done on the boards.
Well, guys, they've done a lot of things well, but their rebounding is right at the top of the list.
Now here's Bird. 8 points for her. Pass to Talbot. Lloyd. Bird right side. And no good. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. Now here's Diggins-Smith. Back to Nurse. Here's Griner. Taurasi. Covered by Lloyd. Taurasi's shot is off. Now here is Stewart, defended by Nurse.
Solid amount of contact on that play, but Stewart's a tough-minded player who can do just about anything down low.
This is her first trip to the free throw line tonight.
Brianna Stewart at the line for two.
Down the first one.
One of the game's best players. Stewart is the type of player you build your franchise around.
That's also good, so she hits them both. And so here's Phoenix. Taurasi with it. She watches it go through the hoop for her eighth make. Now 8 for 14.
Effective around the rim. Taurasi is well-rounded. She can finish with a multitude of moves.
And looks like an illegal pick was set. That'll get the ref's attention.
Well, I just think an illegal screen, it's one of the toughest calls for an official to make.
Yeah, you have to appreciate how difficult a job they have to do when it comes to making calls like that. It's not as easy as people might think.
And the refs in this league just do a great job.
Now here's Nurse. Here's Greiner. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses, and she'll shoot two. And Seattle gets called for the foul. And she'll take her third and fourth free throw shots of the night. The first one falls. And that's good as she hits both shots. A difficult situation for Seattle. To the paint, Stewart. Terrific assist and a nice finish. Just a solid play all around.
Well, there's the all-time leader in WNBA history in assists. Bird knows exactly where to place passes.
Here's Kia Nurse from the arc. Another shot, and it's good. Fought through the contact, hit the shot, and she'll go to the line. The Storm with the ball, trailing by 19. Pass to Talbot. Dupree with it. Burt, she's covered by Taurasi. 5 to shoot. Here's Burt. Kia Nurse the rebound.
That's one she knows she should have drained.
Little. Down low. And the basket by Taurasi.
And that bucket adds to what's been a big differential in points in the paint between these two squads.
Yeah, they're really attacking the middle offensively. It's been quite the contrast.
Here's Burt. Over to the left wing. Here's Talbot. Defended by Nurse. Here's Burt. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Here's Greiner. The basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
She is just tearing it up this quarter, and I don't think this lead is going to go anywhere while she's this hot from the field.
Here's Burt. Outside Stewart, Canada. To end the run! It's hauled in by Diana Taurasi.
Look, if they know what's good for them, that's the way they'll defend against her every time she takes the ball into three-point land.
Well, you're right again, Brian. Anything less than lockdown defense on her, it's going to result in 3 points. You can count on that.
Now here is Canada. 8 points for her. Now a timeout called by Seattle.
Really, they're not pleased at all with the looks they've given up inside, and they want to talk to the team about tightening things up defensively.
Well, that's what's got to happen, and I'm sure the coaches will let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense, and that's a recipe for disaster.
We'll be right back. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Storm will get the ball here.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
Pass to Stewart. Looking to end the drought. And the layup is up and in.
Making it look so effortless. Once Stewart gets rolling, she's like an avalanche on offense.
Walker with it. Offensive rebound. Turner with the bucket.
A big lead for them, both on the scoreboard and the rebounding column.
Well, rebounding has been a big key, asserting their will, and they've taken control.
Now here is Canada. She's got eight. Pass to Burke. Stewart with the ball, and she gets the bucket.
Her quickness and soft touch around the rim, it allows her to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have the reverse in the arsenal.
And here's Walker. And here's Griner. Dupree covering. They double-team Brittany Griner. Hartley, good.
Not by any means a three-point gunner. Hartley makes just enough of these to keep you honest, and it makes you follow her and extend your defense out to the arc.
Inside. Stewart misses. To the inside. Nurse with the bucket.
A nice fast break from start to finish.
And what a finish it was, guys. Just so pretty.
The pass, the dunk, everything.
Now here is Canada. Now Burke. Just four to shoot. And it's out of bounds to the Storm as Seattle retains possession. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Clock is at three. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Straight ball movement to the open player. Samuelson with her head on a swivel.
Pass to Cunningham. And they're going to count the bucket and center to the line. It could be a three-point play.
An incredibly successful shooter in the college game. I can't wait to see everything Cunningham can do here in the pro game.
Now here is Canada. 8 points for her. It's Jewel Lloyd with the drive. Lays it up and banks it in.
She's so good at recognizing where the openings are and getting that ball to the rim.
Outside, Diggin Smith.
Wow, it is a huge day on the glass for a player who's, you know what, they're giving up a lot of size to bigger players out there. Very impressive.
Now here is Canada. Misses and close.
Well, they call them layups for a reason. It's not easy to miss that close to the rim. She's just not been on her game. The deficit, it's really not totally on her, but she hasn't helped the situation.
We're getting a good look at Diggin Smith's crafty handle. She's good at creating off the dribble.
Pass to Samuelson. Lloyd. And the layup's good off the glass.
That's the 10th straight giving up in the paint.
It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they keep allowing easy looks inside.
Here's Rinkakakunwe. Pass to Diggin Smith. And they call an illegal screen here.
The idea of setting a screen on that play, it was the good idea, the right idea, but the execution was not.
Yeah, you really want to set a hard screen, but you also want to make sure it's a legal one.
Now here is Lloyd. Pass to Magvigor. Lloyd. A beautiful reverse layup.
You know, they've been extremely efficient and effective getting the ball inside.
Totally. I mean, we're seeing some real shortcomings from this defense. They've given up five straight good looks in the paint.
Here's Cunningham. Nice D from Jewel Lloyd. Prince's shot's good.
Tremendous find by Lloyd. She's really a combo guard, but she has point guard savvy. Senses when her teammates are open.
Here's Diggins Smith. Misses from short range. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. It's the Mercury delivering the blowout. And we've got more in store for you right after this. And it's time to bring up the State Farm assist of the game.
This was an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for her.
Yeah, she served her up some tasty room service right there, guys. Sweet dime.
We're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Now here's Bird. Outside Lloyd. Inside. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. And she'll shoot one more at the line. It's the Mercury with the ball. Pass to Griner. Turner. Guns up empty down low. Outside Lloyd. Here's Magbegor. To the middle. Lloyd. And they pick up two.
She's starting to turn it on now after a slow start.
And here is Diggins Smith. Puts it up from 15. Magbegor grabs the miss.
Well, despite her ineffectiveness, the team has found other scoring options.
Here's Talbot. Pass to Magbegor. Shot clock at 6. Now here's Dupree. And the shot is good.
A tough, knowledgeable player with good intangibles. Dupree's teammates are constantly picking her brain.
Now here's Taurasi. No good. Had a chance to end the run there. And that's a foul called on Diana Taurasi. That's her first foul. One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
And Sue Bird, here we go. And it's blocked by Skylar Diggins-Smith.
Look, blocking shots is all about staying disciplined, and I like to see Diggins-Smith put her instincts and timing to good use there.
And she should thank the D for those 2 points. Nobody really paying much attention to her there.
Now here is Lloyd. And the Storm miss again. Pass to Diggins-Smith. Yes, it is. Score that as basket number 5 on a 5-for-11 night.
Brings so much intensity to the court. Diggins-Smith energizes her entire team with plays like that.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts and a 3-point play opportunity. One free throw coming up.
They've made every free throw here in the second half.
And look, Tim, you know better than anyone, that efficiency is so crucial when you're looking to overcome a deficit.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Passed a little. Now Griner. Goes up on the baseline. And there's another one for the Mercury.
honestly, when she hits from this area of the court, you might as well quit. It makes Griner almost impossible to stop. You just can't leave her out there.
On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. She's covered by Taurasi.
And the basket by Lloyd.
And she's showing signs of life now after going scoreless through halftime.
Taurasi outside. Pass to Griner. Taurasi.
And again, Phoenix with the triple.
Watch out. Now that she's got her first three of the half, there might be more in store.
Here's Talbot. On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. Here's Talbot, defended by Nurse. That one off the back iron and out. And the Mercury with possession. To the paint, Little. Great D that time from Candace Dupree. Bird outside. Pass to Dupree. Here's Talbot, defended by Nurse. Talbot, no good. Outside, Diggin Smith. Little. And again, it's Phoenix.
With a selfless approach to the game, Diggin Smith takes pride in her ability to create for others.
Outside, Lloyd. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and she'll shoot two. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
Taking two shots.
And the first one falls for her.
Really, arriving on the international stage, Lloyd was part of the 2018 national team, helping the team win the world championships in Spain.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. And it's the Mercury with the ball. Pass to Griner. Nurse. Takes the three. Out of bounds, it'll go to the Storm. Lloyd. She's guarded closely. And she floats it in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
We're seeing her bring that shooting percentage up now, which is good to see because the first half was a real struggle for her.
Basket good.
Lighting it up again. Griner led the WNBA in scoring for a reason. She's expanded her offensive game.
Here's Magvigor. And Brittany Griner with the block. Rossi outside. Pass to Griner. To Rossi. Nice D from Jewel Lloyd. And here's the fast break. Here's Stewart. And Brittany Griner with the block.
Length and vertical jumping ability pay monster dividends for Griner as a rim protector. They're passing the ball very crisply right now.
Their last three buckets have come by way of an assist. They're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half.
And that's the right thing to do with the lead. You want to keep going at defenders and find a way to get to the line.
Get those freebies.
Here's Talbot. Stewart, covered by Little. Back to Stewart. The shot's good on the assist by Jewel Lloyd.
That's just running the mill for her. She's one of the more skilled offensive players out there.
Rossi outside. Pass to Griner. Lays it up and in off the nice reverse.
What a top-notch game she's having. And really, She's got her team in front, and it sure seems like she's going to keep them there if she can continue to play like this.
Seattle calls timeout. Nice game. Great performance by Brittany Griner.
She is on fire on a major roll today. That timeout desperately needed. They've got to come up with a new game plan right now to slow her down.
Canada. Here's Talbot. From past the arc, sinks the triple.
Not the tightest D right there. She'll punish you if she gets the chance. That three-point shot is her bread and butter.
It's Kia Nurse on the wing. Down low, Megan Smith. Down goes basket. 6 for her this game. She's taken 12 shots and made half of them. Pass to Lloyd. Stolen by Diggins Smith. Nurse with it. Inside. And Little gets it to go.
Ooh, an unselfish play from an unselfish player. Griner is a respected locker room figure.
Here's Magbegor. Stewart covered by Little. Pulls up on the elbow. Mercury with the rebound. Diggins Smith with it. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Very close call there on the illegal screen.
But I go along with it. You know, to me, it didn't really look like her feet were set.
Williams. And here's Burke. Up top, Herbert Harrigan. Shot clock at 5. The offensive rebound. And it's good. 2 points.
That takes tremendous focus. Danielson has elite shooting ability, which means she scores when it's hard.
From 7. It's not going to go for her. Now Seattle takes it the other way. Now here's Williams. Pass to Burke. Basket counts.
This run really not doing them any good coming as late as it has.
Yeah, but give them credit for showing the fight they're showing, Tim. It would have been real easy to just throw in the towel by now.
Yeah, but it's still going to be a loss probably.
Here's Cunningham. And the shot goes down.
Enjoy it. Went on, no one scores like Diana Taurasi. She has the most 20-plus point seasons in league history.
Here's Samuelson. Here's Williams. Missed. And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one.